So in the last lecture, we already discussed some of the terms, that is margin and alignment. The definitions, the distance from the text to the paper edge is called margin. We are just recalling the concepts because it's a long time, hai na, week pad gaya beech mein. So that's why, just in brief, after that you will be presenting your document that I have given you as the home task. So be ready your documents. Left margin, right, top and bottom. This question was in test also yesterday. So you have attempted the test. You might have got the answers as well as marks. Every one of you. Dekhe the apne marks. Yes or no? Alignment, the text alignment within a paragraph with respect to the margin is known as alignment. So we discussed four types of alignment. Then we discussed three types of indents, positive, hanging and negative. All these things we have covered. We have also studied that what is line spacing, the spacing between the lines, or you can say that the total height of line of text including the extra spacing. So three types of line spacing we discussed. Orientation. Now this is the new topic. Orientation means how you want your document is to be printed, whether it should be printed lengthwise or it should be printed breadthwise. So two types of orientation are portrait and landscape. If you are choosing the orientation as portrait, so that means your text, your page will be printed lengthwise. Okay, is tarah se vertically print hoga. And if you want your page to be printed breadthwise, that is horizontally, so that is the landscape option. All right, the orientation is clear. So you this option you will find under that page dialog box, format menu, page option, then page dialog box will open. Under that you will get this option. Okay, portrait and landscape. Now let's look at some of the shortcut keys. Bold, control plus B, italic, control plus I, underline, control plus U, new document, control plus N, open existing document, control plus O. So learn it with me. First five I have speak that then you will learn it side by side. First five, be quick. Bold, control plus B, italic, control plus I, underline, control plus U, new document, control plus N, open existing, control plus O. Done, done. The common shortcut keys and that is available for every software. Agar aap MS Word bhi karte to bhi yahi thi. Okay, done yahan tak. Now save, control plus S. Save as, control plus shift plus S. ये मैंने आपको बताया था, नोट डाउन भी करने को बोला था. सेव की कंट्रोल प्लस एस, सेव एज कंट्रोल प्लस शिफ्ट प्लस एस. ओके, नाउ क्लोज डॉक्यूमेंट कंट्रोल प्लस डब्ल्यू. एंड व्हेन यू वांट टू एग्जिट द राइटर, आपको एप्लीकेशन ही बंद करनी है, कंट्रोल प्लस क्यू और ऑल प्लस एफ फोर. Control plus Q or Alt plus F4. Left alignment, Control plus L. Right alignment, Control plus R. Center, Control plus E. Justified, Control plus J. Left alignment, Control plus L. Right, Control plus R. Center, Control plus E. Justified, Control plus J. Undo, redo, ये आप हर सॉफ्टवेयर में यूज करते हो तो आपको पता होगा, कंट्रोल प्लस जी एंड कंट्रोल प्लस वाई. पता है ना? यस. सो द अंडो शॉर्टकट की इज कंट्रोल प्लस जी, रीडो कंट्रोल प्लस वाई, सिलेक्ट एंटायर डॉक्यूमेंट कंट्रोल प्लस ए, सिलेक्ट एंटायर डॉक्यूमेंट कंट्रोल प्लस ए, कॉपी कंट्रोल प्लस सी, cut control plus x, paste control plus v, print control plus p. Learn it with me right now. It's not a big task. You can do it right now. Copy Control plus C, cut Control plus X. Spelling and grammar F7. Spelling and grammar F7. Non-printing characters Control plus F10. Non-printing characters Control plus F10. Find and replace. अब एमएस वर्ड में जब आप जब भी फाइंड एंड रिप्लेस करते थे बच्चे तो फाइंड की होती थी कंट्रोल प्लस एफ बट रिप्लेस की शॉर्टकट की थी कंट्रोल प्लस एच बट इन राइटर आइदर यू वांट टू फाइंड और यू वांट टू रिप्लेस द शॉर्टकट की सेम इन राइटर दैट इज कंट्रोल प्लस एफ एमएस वर्ड में रिप्लेस की शॉर्टकट की कंट्रोल प्लस एच होती है ओके बट इन राइटर द शॉर्टकट की इज सेम फॉर बोथ टेबल कंट्रोल प्लस F12 Control plus F12. Save as Control plus Shift plus S. Control plus Shift plus S. Now let's look at the options. Now the question can be which option belongs to which menu? So both ways you should know the answer. Which menu or which option belongs to which menu? So new option is in File menu, Open File. Close file menu, exit file menu, print file menu, save as file menu. Now question can be like this also. Name any five options under file menu. If you will learn this way, so you can automatically give the answer, okay? Options under file menu. So the options under file menu are new, open, close, exit, print, save, save as. I already told you, on every toolbar you have to learn 10 options plus under every menu too you have to learn 8 to 10 options each and every menu along with the toolbars okay now cut copy paste select all find and replace these five options are under edit menu cut copy paste select all find and replace cut copy paste select all find and replace now insert menu the options under insert menu when you want to insert any special character you want to insert header and footer picture table all right so these options are under insert menu okay ओके बच्चे ऑप्शंस अंडर इंसर्ट मेन्यू आर स्पेशल कैरेक्टर हेडर फुटर पिक्चर टेबल नाउ ऑप्शंस अंडर फॉर्मेट मेन्यू कैरेक्टर पैराग्राफ पेज अलाइनमेंट चेंज केस ग्रुप बुलेट एंड नंबरिंग फॉर्मेट मेन्यू की ऑप्शंस क्या है कैरेक्टर आप इसको टेबुलर फॉर्म बना के लर्न करना ओके मेक अ सेपरेट टेबल फॉर ईच ऑफ द मेन्यू Character, paragraph, page, alignment, change case, group, bullet and numbering. Spelling and grammar option is in tools menu. Spelling and grammar option is in tools menu. Split cell, merge cells option belong to the table menu. Split cell and merge cell belongs to table menu. Auto format is also in the table menu. Gallery option is in tools menu clear the gallery option is in tools menu so you have to learn the options under each menu any doubt to anyone the options are clear bacche now let's do the things practically so this is the writer interface you can see So just look at the cursor where I am moving my mouse pointer. You can see the first bar. This is the title bar, right? This is the title bar and it is having the name Untitled 1. By default, the name is Untitled 1. Then you will save it. Then you will give it a name. So whatsoever name will give, that will appear on the title bar. And on the right side, see three buttons are there. The three control buttons are there. Minimize, maximize, and close. So if you will click on this close button, the writer application will get close. All right. Then you will click the close button on the title bar, the writer application will get close. Next, under the title bar, there is a menu bar. The options, the menus on the menu bar are file, edit, view, insert, format, table, tools, window, help. Now you can see a close button towards the right side of menu bar too. If you will click on this close button available on the menu bar, so this will close the current document of writer, not the application. Writer will be staying there, but only the current document on which you are working, the active document will get closed. The difference is clear. Close button on the title bar and close button on the menu bar. Title bar se kya hoga? The document, the application will get closed. But from here, close document, this is the name, close document means only the active document will get closed. Now after that, there is a standard toolbar. So let's look at the options that are present on the standard toolbar. New, open, save, document as email, export directly as PDF when you want to make your document in the PDF format. Then print option, page preview, spelling and grammar, auto spell check, cut, copy, paste. Now very important option on the standard toolbar, that is format paintbrush. We will study this also. Then undo, redo, table, gallery, show, draw function. Then navigator, find and replace option. So this is also available on the standard toolbar. So again, you got the two methods, and shortcut key control plus F. Then we discuss the option is under the edit menu. The third method of find and replace, that is available on the standard toolbar. So this is non-printing characters. We have studied the concept of non-printing characters now. Then after that, there is a formatting toolbar. All the options related to the formatting will be available on the formatting toolbar. Under formatting toolbar, these are the rulers which are used to set your margin positions. And this is the work area where you are going to type the document, and towards the right side, it's a properties panel. Whatever the option you are using, the properties are available on the right side. And at the bottom, the status bar is appearing. Right now, you can see the drawing toolbar is not available. It is not visible. So what is the command for enabling? You will go to the view menu, toolbars. We have already discussed this command. So look carefully, what is the command for enabling any toolbar, or you can disable the toolbar also from this method. View, toolbar. Under the toolbar, the various toolbars are available, whichever the toolbar you want to make it available. So simply click on that. For example, if right now I want to show the drawing toolbar, so I will click on drawing. Okay, view toolbars, then a particular toolbar. So I clicked on the drawing now. So you can see above the status bar, the drawing toolbar is available. Visible, drawing toolbar. Above the status bar, right? Okay, now let's look at the options under the file menu. New, open, close, save, save as, save all, export, export as PDF. अब हमें कितने documents होते हैं जब आप हम बोलते हैं कि PDF बना के भेजो अपने document की. So this way you will be doing both in the writer, and then you will save it as PDF. You will choose the option export as PDF. Page preview, print, exit. Okay. Options under edit menu, undo, redo, cut, copy, paste, paste special, select all, changes, find and replace. So main options we have to do. You already know I'm repeating again and again the options in the class too. So view, toolbars, status bar, ruler, नेविगेटर, साइड बार. अब कईयों के घर पे जब आपने इंस्टॉल किया होगा राइटर, इट माइट बी से यू हैव नोटिस दैट प्रॉपर्टीज योर साइड बार इज नॉट अपियरिंग. सो यू कैन सी द साइड बार इज अपियरिंग इन माय स्क्रीन बिकॉज आई हैव एक्टिवेटेड हियर. तो जिनका भी यहाँ पे नहीं शो हो रहा होगा, सो यू जस्ट हैव टू गो टू द व्यू मेन्यू and enable the sidebar option. So you will get this panel. Okay. Under the insert fields option. Now you can see under the fields option when you want to insert date. So command kya banegi? Insert menu fields option date option. Insert fields then date sub option. Similarly, you can insert time, insert fields time sub option. If you want to do the page numbering in the writer, insert fields page number, title, author. So the command is insert fields, and under the fields, these options you can insert. Okay. Then if you want to insert header and footer, endnote, footnotes. So again, these are the options which are available under the insert menu. After that, you want to insert table, you want to insert picture, any movie and sound object, right? So objects, if you want to insert any chart, so these options are available under the insert menu. Format, character, paragraph, bullets and numbering, page, change case, columns. Then alignment, grouping, object. All right, so object option will be highlighted when you will work with the drawing toolbar. Options under table, insert, delete, auto format, formula, tools mein humne options padhi hai, spelling and grammar, footnote, endnote, gallery, mail merge, autocorrect. So these five options are the main options that we have to study under the tools, spelling and grammar, gallery, mail merge, autocorrect. Clear? Any doubt in the menus? Now just let me show you the practical concept of margins that we are not able to do in the last lecture because the system got corrupt. Okay. So you can see now this is my text I have already written here. So this way, just by dragging the mouse, you have to select the text. Okay. So this way you are going to select the text in the writer. So let's say now I have selected this first paragraph. You want to set the margins. So this way you can increase or decrease your left margin. So see, I'm able to change my left margin, how much space I want to set from the rulers. So this is the way by which you will set your left margin. From here, I'm going to change the right margin. Okay. From here, this ruler, top margin. And at last, you can set the bottom margin. Right? Any doubt in the margins? The margin portion is clear. Yes, bache? Now. Who is raising hand? Write your query in the chat box, bache. Okay, now the next is the indents. So this is the positive indent. You can see the boundary line is given, a gray boundary line is there. Then you will shift your text inward, so that is the positive indent. Three types of indents we have studied now. Hanging. Lovelina, I have shown the top margin only. Where are you? I have already shown the top margin, bache. Sabse pehle maine top margin hi kiya, then I did that left, right, and bottom. Okay, once again, I'm showing you the margins. So from here, you can now see the space that is coming around the document. A gray border is coming. So from here, you can set your margins. So yahan se dekho, main apna left margin set kar rahi. And when you have to set the top margin, so from here, you can reduce or increase the space. This is the top margin. Now, is it visible? Yes, Lavlina and Ashmit. This is the top margin, how we are setting it. Okay. Now next, bache, I was telling you regarding the positive indent. when you are moving the text like this, so this is the positive indent because the text is flowing inside the margin area. Margin se bahar nahi ja raha aapka text. So when the text is inside the margin area, so this is the positive indent. What do we call this? This is the positive indent. Clear? Now, when I'm taking my data outwards of the margin area, so you can see this is the negative indent. When the text is flowing outside the margins, margins ke bahar ja raha hai, to isko hum kya bolenge? This is the negative indent. The third type of indent is hanging indent, in which you are just moving the first line. This is the hanging indent. Means only one line is indented and rest of the text is on the same margin level. Three types of indents are clear: positive, negative, and hanging. Any doubt? Positive, negative, and hanging indent. From the formatting toolbar, you can give the highlighting to your text. You can also change the font color. Formattings can be applied from the formatting toolbar. Now see, one option I just want to show you, the format paintbrush. Now what is format paintbrush? Suppose in a document you want to apply the same formatting to a number of things. For example, in your document, let's say you are having 10 to 13 headings are there. So, kya aap 10 headings pe individually formatting apply karoge if you want to make the formatting same, if you want to keep the formatting same? No. Ho sakta hai aapne 3-4 operations lagaye ho apni heading ke upar and every time you are just making the same heading, to aapko koi ek aadhi option beech mein skip kar gaya mind se ki acha bold bhi karna tha, italic bhi karna tha, underline bhi karna tha. It can be possible na ki aapko underline bhool gaya beech mein when you are copying so many things. So what we can do is, when you want to keep the formatting same, we are having one option, that is format paintbrush. Format paintbrush. So this formatting I want to apply on positive and indent rather than ki main isko manually karu. What can I do is, I do not want to perform it manually. I will just select this. Now the option is the format paintbrush on the standard toolbar. The option is format paintbrush. I will copy this form, this formatting. Now you can see a fill symbol is available. So wherever I want to copy this formatting, I will just click on that. So see, on indent, my formatting has been copied. Now every time you have to firstly copy the formatting and then click on the word where you want to apply the same formatting. So this way, I can apply the formatting and make our document consistent. Consistence means same kind of formatting is being applied. So this way you can simply drag it and apply the formatting. So the use of paintbrush is clear. The paintbrush option is available on standard toolbar, right? Maine isko manually nahi kiya, just I have performed the formatting operations on one text. I will copy its formatting and that copied formatting can be applied to any number of lines, but repeatedly you just have to copy it. Kyunki jab aap copy karenge to ek hi bari copy hoga aur ek hi bari uski formatting paste hogi. Any doubt in the format paintbrush? Positive indent diya bachche, see, this is the margin area, the gray line, gray border of the margins. Jab aapka text margin area ke andar andar reh raha hai, that is the positive indent. When your text is flowing outside the margin area, so this is called negative indent. You can see line ke bahar ja raha hai text, so this is the negative indent. And when you have to write any paragraph like you used to write in English, to aap pehli line slightly si thodi indenting karte ho, towards the right side. So you can see यहाँ पे मेरी space आ रही है, लेकिन बाकी मेरा tag same आ रहा है. So this is the hanging index. All right. So we discussed practically types of margins, types of indents, and then format paintbrush. Any doubt? Now let's do alignments also. So for setting the alignments, you can see the alignment buttons are available on the formatting toolbar, left, right, center, and justify. Now if I want to make my document, make my text aligned towards the right side, so you can see this is the left alignment. You can see left side se mera bilkul same level pe content aa raha hai, but on the right side it is not aligned. Content aage ja raha hai, second line mein content beech mein reh raha hai, last line mein languages fir aage ja rahi hai, but on the left side if you will see first character of every word is same at same level. So this is the left align. Okay, now next, the right alignment. Now I want to, so you can see this is the right alignment. First one is the left alignment, right one is second one is the right alignment. Now from left side it is not on the same level, but you can see towards the right side the text is on the same level. Now if I want to do the center alignment, so see, this is the center alignment. Yeah, now the same text I'm going to copy down. So when using justified, it is on the same level from left and right side as well. Left alignment, this is the right alignment. Center, the text will be flowing in the center, but in justified it will take both the left and right margins. Alignments are clear. Now let's look at the methods for the alignment. You can choose any alignment from the formatting toolbar. This is the first method. Secondly, you can use shortcut keys. Already we have discussed Control plus L, Control plus E, J, and R, the shortcut keys. Third option, third method, bache, see, format paragraph. Under the paragraph dialog box, we are having the alignment tab. The third method is using the command format menu paragraph option. Under the paragraph option, kya hamare paas open ho raha hai? Paragraph dialog box. And under this box, go to the alignment tab and choose the particular alignment options. So three methods by which you can choose the alignments, you can give the alignment formatting. So note down the three methods to set alignment. Three methods to set alignment. So the three methods for the alignment are: choose a particular alignment on the formatting toolbar, then you can choose shortcut keys. Third method, using the command format menu paragraph option. Clear? Any doubt in the today's lecture? You can see bache the formatting toolbar options also. Firstly, you just have to select the text and then apply the desired formatting options. From here you can change the font face, the font name. Okay, then from here you will choose the size of the font, bold, italic, underline. These options you can give. Then the alignments we have already discussed. So this is a bullet and numbering feature. We will do it later on. Now increase indent and decrease indent. See, If I will click on this, so see, indents are increasing, means this is the positive indent, okay? So you can decrease indent this way. So this is the negative indent. Decrease indent means negative indent ho raha hai. Increase indent means positive indent. Clear? So this way you can increase or decrease the indent. Then font color, you can choose the font color from here. Highlighting, from here you can give the highlighting. This is the background. When you want to give the background fill of a particular text, so you can see on this line, text color yahan pe maine diya hua hai. So this is the option called font color. Then highlighting, you want to give highlighting of a text, so this is the highlighting. Uske piche kya aa raha hai? Background. Background to a selected text. So background yahan se maine diya hua tha purple. So you can see the mauve shade that is appearing as a background. Agar yahan pe aap highlighting nahi denge to wo pura ka pura fir mauve shade hi rahega. So see, ab maine no fill kar diya hai. I have done the no fill. So this is the background to a text. So the background to the text is mauve. But if you want to give highlighting, so let's see, if I just want to give highlighting to the ICT only, so I can give, I can select the text and highlighting can be there. Clear the concept of font color, highlighting and background. Tino aap kaise laga sakte ho? The background will be at last. Theek hai? Yes, Ashmit. Yes, Ashmit, are you saying anything, bachche?
Ma'am, ek baar, ma'am, can you, ma'am, repeat the, ma'am, three methods to set alignment?
So these are the three methods. See, first method is using the formatting toolbar. Ye formatting toolbar pe options hai na, left, right, center, and justify. Secondly, just you have to select the text. Like I'm selecting the text, and I'm using the shortcut key Control plus F. So see, the text is left aligned now. So shortcut key you can choose from the keyboard. The third method is using the command format menu paragraph option. Under the paragraph option, the paragraph dialog box will get open. Under this box, the various tabs will appear. You have to click the alignment tab. Let me show you. Format, paragraph, alignment. So see, the alignment options are available here. Okay. So whatever the alignment you want to choose, you can choose it.
शॉर्टकट की इसमें हम कंट्रोल प्लस एफ
नो बच्चे व्हाट हैपेंड टू यू हमने अभी तो डिस्कस करी है कंट्रोल प्लस एल फॉर लेफ्ट अलाइन कंट्रोल प्लस आर फॉर राइट अलाइन कंट्रोल प्लस
दैट्स
जे जस्टिफाई एंड कंट्रोल प्लस ई फॉर द सेंटर अलाइन दीस कीज यू हैव टू प्रेस फ्रॉम द कीबोर्ड
ओके ओके
क्लियर
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, bachche. Rest of the options we will do in the next lecture, practically only. So I hope today's practical is clear to you, to everyone.